Ayun, magandang araw po sa inyong lahat and welcome to my channel. Salamat sa pagdaan nyo ngayong araw. Shoutout dyan syempre sa mga kaibigan natin na mga crypto investors, no? Mga viewers natin na crypto investors and crypto enthusiasts. Comment lang kayo mga kapatid, like and subscribe. This content is precisely for you. And syempre para na rin sa mga Pinoy o mga kababayan natin na gustong silipin nga yung mundo ni crypto. As always, this is not a financial advice. This is me documenting my crypto journey and sharing my curiosity and love for knowledge, especially about the technology that may very well transform our lives and civilization. Okay, so here's a quick market recap. Total market cap of the cryptocurrency is 938 billion, down by 5.47% in the last 24 hours. So kahapon po, 4 billion na lang ay may hit na uli natin yung 1 trillion market cap, no? But fortunately, because of the Bitcoin dump, I believe nag-start kagabi, madaling araw at hanggang ngayon, apektado syempre lahat ng mga cryptocurrencies, lahat ng altcoins. Kung ano yung galaw ni Bitcoin ay meron po yung epekto sa mga altcoins, no, or coins na maliban sa Bitcoin. So as you can see here, no, si Bitcoin po is priced at 18,772, down by 5% in the last 24 hours, followed by ETH, which is at 1,514, and followed by stable coins like Tether, USDT, USDC, and then followed by BNB, Binance, BUSD, XRP, Cardano, Solana, and Dogecoin. Yun po yung top 10. And the rest, as we can see it, no, it's actually medyo namumula po halos lahat, no? Okay, namumula po talaga sila. At dahil nga, as you can see nga dito sa yung graph dito, no, sa right side, yung pinaka right side, you can see there, no, alas namumula. Yung green lang po dyan is yung mga stable coins or yung mga coins that are pegged to a dollar. So alas $1 yung kanilang price, eh, no. So yan, so talagang namumula po siya, no? Wala pong nakaligtas dyan. Ito, gulat tayo sa nangyari kagabi. Although there's a an upcoming big event, no, big event sa crypto, yung Ethereum merge, and then yung maningyari naman sa Cardano, yung Vasil hard fork will be happening sa Cardano sa September 22nd, and for Ethereum naman ay sa September 15. I think yung price ngayon is very juicy, no, kung sino man yung nagdi-DCA or nagda-dollar cost average, kung sino man yung nagdadagdag sa kanilang portfolio, it's very nice. The prices are very nice kasi nga sobrang baba. Although mahal yan, pero if you're like if you're an investor and you're expecting for the prices to go like 100x, 200x, no, these prices are very cheap. Especially that the prices of these coins, most of them, no, is 90% lower compared to the all-time high, no. Okay, so pakita ko lang po sa inyo yung nangyari kagabi regarding dito sa Bitcoin dump, no, na tinatawag. So as you can see po dito, no, for ilang days na nga tayong naglalaro from the price na 19,900 to 20,000, no, to 19,600, and yun lang po siya, naglalaro lang po siya doon, consolidating, and then last night we saw that big dump. Ito pong mahabang line na to, if you will zoom in, no, kakatakot po yun sa mga investors. Dahil yung, for example po, bumili ka po ng isang Bitcoin ng halaga ay 19,600, bigla pong, or 19,500, ganyan, bigla pong nag-dump nga, no? At inabot na nga po dito, ngayon ang kanyang current price is nasa 18,781. So you are down significantly by almost $1,000, no? Almost $1,000. So around 56,000, mga ganun sa atin yan. So you're down by 56,000. But if you're like a Bitcoin, a long-term Bitcoin holder, so hindi mo to papansinan because you will realize and you are forecasting na this is temporary and it will probably there's still a way down because some analysts and some experts believe that hindi pa ito yung bottom ni Bitcoin. They believe that it can still go down hanggang $10,000. $10,000 to $12,000, $14,000, $15,000, and the currently nga nasa $18,777 pa lang tayo nga sa Bitcoin, and there's a chance for that to go down to that prices na nabanggit ko. And syempre nga kung bumababa si Bitcoin at yun nga yung kanyang price, right? Kung yun nga yung price niya, is syempre yun din yung susundan po. Yun din yung susundan nga nung mga altcoins. Kasi whatever the price of Bitcoin, di ba po, yun din po yung magiging takbo. Yung magiging takbo nga nitong ni Bitcoin. So it can still go down. No, it can still go down pababa before it moves up again. So as you can see here on CoinGlass po, no, sa trading, so 62% ay trading long, and then 37% are trading short. So mas marami po ngayon na nag-expect na tataas yung value from the 18,000 price. And nakikita po natin dito sa Binance, 66% trading long, 34% is trading short. Then for Kraken, 66.95%. This is surprising kasi normally mga nagka-Kraken, mga gumagamit ng Kraken, normally they are bearish, meaning they're expecting for the price to go low or down. And dito naman si Bitfinex, ito medyo bullish na siya kasi 93.53% nga sinasabi niya na it can go up, no, or can go the price can go up, and only 15% are trading short. Okay, that's it for trading view and trading update. Let me give you some important and good news naman. So ito sa mga news talaga namang medyo kinatawa natin kasi nga of course Singapore is an economic hub. Their economy is centered mainly to financial services. Sila ang gateway of foreign investment among Asian countries, headquarters of multinational companies. They are practically building the bridge from east to west markets. That is why when you see this kind of news, if you are a crypto long-term investor, you will love this, and you will love why you are positioned nga dito sa market, no? As you can see on the news dito, sinabi nga na Singapore's biggest bank, DBS, backs crypto despite market slump. Okay? And sinabi nga dito, no, Singapore's biggest bank plans to grow its cryptocurrency and digital assets. So mas gusto nilang palakihin yung kanilang holding or yung kanilang position sa crypto market. And saying it wants to expand its digital exchange and offer services to more of its 300,000 wealthy clients in Asia. O, sabi nga po ng kanilang chief executive na si Puyush Gupta, said that the market, crypto market downturn proved that established and regulated financial institutions rather than just startups should be offering products such as digital asset trading for retail investors. So they want to be involved yung mga malalaking financial institution instead of just letting, like for example, Binance, Coinbase, and other exchanges to lead the way in terms of cryptocurrency. Sabi ni Gupta, gusto niya na yung kanilang bank is involved and have a larger position nga pagdating sa cryptocurrency. And might not be able to read the whole article or forgive you the whole article. Probably you can read it na lang. But the gist of the whole news is that they want to regulate it. So meaning they want to stay sa kanilang bansa. And sinasabi nga dito that the banks or brokerage arm last year received a cryptocurrency license from the Monetary Authority of Singapore. So meaning nagkaroon sila ng parang license to operate and to deal with cryptocurrency nga, allowing its institutional and wealthy clients, yung mga clients ng bank na DBS to participate nga sa cryptocurrency. Ayun. And they want it nga regulated. So this is a very good news. The whole article, if you will read it, I believe it will will make you happy if you're a crypto investor. They want to be a crypto hub. They want to be like Dubai. Si Dubai po kasi is a crypto hub. And ayun nga po, no, despite the this year's crypto collapse na katulad po ni Terra Luna, Terra Labs, and Celsius, Three Arrows Capital, andun pa rin sila, no? They really want to be involved with cryptocurrency, and I believe this country is just waiting for a clear regulations pa. But as the current setup, they want to participate, they're very bullish on crypto, and they want to be on a stronger position. Probably more position na sila para pagdating ng bull market ay maganda yung position nila. Ito nga po, na isang bansa na naman, si Russia, to legalize use of cryptocurrency in international trade. Okay, so before, no, by report po na si Russia is banning po si cryptocurrency nga sa kanilang bansa, because precisely they want it to be regulated muna bago sila pasukin, bago nila payagan yung mga tao nila, yung mga Russians, to participate in crypto, kasi baka since it's unregulated pa nga, most likely baka maraming mga Russians yung mga malugi when they invest on crypto, since napaka volatile, and they saw ngayong nangyari sa Celsius, Terra Labs, Three Arrows Capital po, no? So that is why they have this temporary ban. But seeing this news to they are legalizing use of cryptocurrency nga sa international trade is I believe again is a good news for long term crypto investors. Same nga din po yun ng news kay Iran, no? So Iranian businesses get the green light to use crypto for import. So it's the same concept, it's the same news like that of Russia, that they are allowing payments or transaction using cryptocurrency for imports, for international trades and transactions. Okay, sumaglit po naman tayo sa UK nga. Ito po si Liz Truss, ang pinakabagong Prime Minister ng UK. And this was a tweet noong 2018, no, para lang makita natin yung stand nga ni Liz Truss about cryptocurrency. No, sabi niya po dito, "We should welcome # cryptocurrencies in a way that doesn't constrain their potential. Liberate free enterprise areas by removing regulations that restrict prosperity. # policy exchange. # future of freedom. # shake up." Kayo po, kung kayo yung kayo ay isang long-term crypto investor, or ngayon lang yung narinig si Listrus or ngayon lang kayo nakabalita about cryptocurrency, what will you feel? No? Just place your comment below. When you see this kind of stand or tweet from Listrus, which is currently the Prime Minister of UK. So kaka-announce lang po na siya na nga yung pinakabagong Prime Minister. Pinalitan niya si Boris. At eto na nga no, yung hinihintay natin na news about Listrus, na alam naman nating supporter nga ng cryptocurrency. Siya ang ang pinakabagong Prime Minister ng UK, no? Let's see kung anong mga moves ang gagawin niya that is related to cryptocurrency. Sabi niya nga dito sa tweet, no, I'm honored to be elected leader of the Conservative Party. Thank you for putting your trust in me to lead and deliver for our great country. I will take bold action to get all of us through this tough times, grow our economy, and unleash the United Kingdom's potential. So, let's wait and see lang siguro. Waiting game tayo dito. Kung anong mga moves nga yung gagawin ni Listrus that will be related nga to cryptocurrency. At ito naman, syempre, yung mga excited dyan na mag-upgrade na ng kanilang mga PC. Baka makakita tayo ng price drop ng mga GPU because of Ethereum's plan to move nga from proof of work to proof of stake. Kaya may ganito pong news that, again, sinasabi po dito, First Mover Asia, Ethereum's merge starts to hit gaming chip prices. Kasi nga po, yung alam naman natin, pag nagmamine ng ETH currently is still proof of work, they're using yung mga equipments, yung mga GPUs that are using chips, that are using very sophisticated GPU. And since hindi na nga sila gagamit nun, since they will be transitioning to a proof of work or proof of stake, we probably can see price drop on GPUs. So, ganun po yun. So, huwag ka munang, kung plano ako mag-upgrade, hintay mo na, baka makuha mo ng very cheap nga. That's it for today. Hopefully, kahit paano, may nakuha kayo from this video. And just be careful out there if you're trading, if you're doing dollar cost average. Ako malis muna ako, hindi muna ako hindi muna ako bumibili because I'm waiting for a lower, much lower price to maximize my capital. So yun, just check nyo lang po every time, no? Baka mamaya hindi nyo napansin, bigla na naman bumaba and you lose that opportunity to buy in a much lower price, no? So yun, sana okay lang kayo lahat. Maraming salamat po sa pagdaan sa aking channel. See you next time. Bye for now.